So in this video we'll discuss chapter 4 linear equations in two variables. So for this you should be knowing coordinate geometry. So if you want to revise that chapter, you can click on the link above. So let's talk about exercise 4.1, chapter 4 linear equations in two variables. So in this we'll be plotting graphs of linear equations in two variables, and we'll be solving, framing out equations, we'll be finding out solutions of an equation. So let's talk about exercise 4.1. So in exercise 4.1, the first question is, the cost of a notebook is twice the cost of a pen. Write a linear equation in two variables to represent this statement. So let the cost of the notebook be rupees X and the cost of the pen be rupees Y. So cost of notebook is X, is equal to twice means 2. The cost of a pen, the cost of pen is y. So x is equal to 2y. This is the solution. This is the equation, required linear equation. So let's talk about second question. Express the following linear equations in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So we have to express a linear the following linear equations in this form. So first part is 2x plus 3y is equal to 9.35 bar. So firstly c is on left hand side, so take this constant on left hand side. So this will be 2x plus 3y minus 9.35 bar is equal to 0. So we can say a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3, c is equal to minus of 9.35 bar. So this is the required form. Second, x minus y by 5 minus 10 is equal to 0. So this is already in this form. So here a value is equal to 1, b is minus 1 by 5, c is equal to minus 10. C is minus 10. Next, third part, minus of 2x plus 3y is equal to 6. So here a is equal to minus 2, b is equal to 3, and if we rewrite this equation, this will be minus 2x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. So c is equal to minus 6. This is the answer. You can also write a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 3, and c is equal to plus 6. Next, fourth part, x is equal to 3y. So this can be written as x minus 3y is equal to 0. So we can say a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 3, and c is equal to 0, as there is no constant term. Next, fifth part. So fifth part is 2x is equal to minus 5y. So we can write down this as 2x plus 5y is equal to 0. So we can say a is equal to 2, b is equal to 5, c is equal to 0. Next, sixth part. You can pause the video and you can solve yourself, and later on you can check, is equal to 0. So we can say a is equal to 3, b is 0 as there is no y variable, so, and c is equal to 2. Seventh part, y minus 2 is equal to 0. So we can say a is equal to 0 as there is no x variable. This can also be written as 0x plus y minus 2 is equal to 0. This can, sixth part can also be written as 3x plus 0y plus 2 is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This equation can also be written as 2x plus 5y plus c plus 0 is equal to 0, as constant is already 0. So a is equal to 0, b is equal to 1, and c is equal to minus 2. Next, eighth part. So in eighth part we have 5 is equal to 2x, or we can say this as 2x minus 5 is equal to 0, or we can say 2x plus 0y minus 5 is equal to 0. So a is equal to 2, b is equal to 0, and c is equal to minus 5. These are the answers. So let's move on to next exercise, exercise 4.2. So in exercise 4.2, question number first, which one of the following option is true and why? So the equation is given, इक्वेशन इज y इज इक्वल टू 3x प्लस 5. सो इट हैज़ यूनिक सॉल्यूशन, ओनली टू सॉल्यूशन, इनफाइनाइटली मैनी सॉल्यूशंस. सो हेयर वी कैन सी फॉर एवरी वैल्यू ऑफ x वील हैव डिफरेंट वैल्यू ऑफ y. फॉर एवरी डिफरेंट वैल्यू ऑफ x वील हैव डिफरेंट वैल्यू ऑफ y. इफ x इज 0, y इज 5. इफ x इज 1, y इज 8. इफ x इज 2, y इज 3 मल्टीप्लाई 2, 6, 6 प्लस 5, 11. सो फॉर एवरी डिफरेंट वैल्यू ऑफ x, फॉर एवरी डिफरेंट वैल्यू ऑफ x, we have different value of y. So that means it has infinitely many solutions. So C option is correct. Option C is correct. Next, second question. Write four solutions of each of the following equations. So this is very necessary as we are going to use this for plotting graphs also. So 2x plus y is equal to 7. So we have to write down four solutions. So first make a column, make a table in this way. 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this one 5th. So x, y, we have to write down four solutions. So if x is, if we can say if x is 0, so if x is 0, what will be the value of y? So y will be equal to 7, since 0 multiplied 2 is 0, so y is 7. If x is 1, if x is 1, so y will be equal to 7 minus 2x, 7 minus 2, which is 5. So y is 5. Similarly, if x is 2, so you can take any values of x. So if x is 2, put x is equal to 2 into this. 2 multiplied 2 is 4. 7 minus 4 is y is equal to 7 minus 4, which is 3. So y is 3. If x is 3, 3 multiplied 2 is 6. So y will be equal to, we can say here, if x is equal to 3, y is equal to 3 multiplied 2, 6. 7 minus 6 is 1, so y is 1. So these are four solutions. So for every different value of x, we can have different value of y. You can choose any four values of x and get any four, and any four values of y, get the four solutions of y. You can choose any four values of y and get different values of x. So it's all up to you. Next, second part. So let's take second part of this. So second part we have, second part, pi x plus y is equal to 9. So four solutions we have to take. So if x is equal to 0, so this implies pi multiplied 0 plus y is equal to 9. So second part we have pi x plus y is equal to 0. So if x is 0, put x is equal to 0 into this. So pi multiplied 0 plus y is equal to 9, or we can say y is equal to 9. If x is 1, so put x is equal to 1, pi multiply 1 plus y is equal to 9. So we can say y is equal to 9 minus pi. If x is 2, put x is equal to 2 into this plus y is equal to 9. Or we can say y is equal to 9 minus 2 pi. Pi multiply 2 is 2 pi. If x is equal to 3, so this implies pi multiply 3 plus y is equal to 9. Or we can say y is equal to 9 minus 3 pi. So make a table. So for different values of x, we have different values of y. So four solutions we have to determine. So x, y. So if x is 0, 1, 2, 3. Y is 9, 9 minus pi, 9 minus 2 pi. 9 minus 3 pi. You can take any four values of x or any four values of one variable and get other four values for other variable, different variable. So next, third part, x is equal to 4y. So if x is equal to 4y, so for every different values of y, we have different values of x. So if y is equal to 0, so put y is equal to 0, this implies x is equal to 4 multiply 0. Or we can say x is equal to 0. If y is 1, put x, y is equal to 1. So 4 multiply 1, this is 4. So which is 4. If y is 2, so we can say x is equal to 4 multiply 2, विच इज 8. इफ y इज 3, सो x इज इक्वल टू 4 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 3 विच इज 12. सो वी हैव 4 सॉल्यूशंस हियर. सो राइट डाउन इन अ टेबुलर वे. सो y इज इक्वल टू 0, 1, 2, 3. सो x इज इक्वल टू 0, 4, 8, 12. For y is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. For y is equal to 1, x is equal to 4. Y is equal to 2, x is equal to 8. Y is equal to 3, x is equal to 12. Next, fourth part. Sorry, we have only three parts. So next, third question. Check which of the following are the solutions of the equation x minus 2y is equal to 4. X minus 2y is equal to 4. And which are not. So let's see. So first part. 0, 2. So this implies x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 2. So just put the values of x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 2 into this equation and check whether LHS is equal to RHS. So 0, once when we'll put x with 0, if x is equal to 0, minus 2, y is 2 is equal to 4. So this implies minus 4 is equal to 4. So since minus 4 is not equal to 4, so no. This is not a solution of it. Second part, 2, 0. So put x is equal to 2 into this. This implies x is equal to 2, y is equal to 0. So 2 minus 2 bracket 0 is should be equal to 4. So 2 is equal to 4. Since we all know 2 is never equal to 4. So this implies no, this is also not a solution. Third part, 4, 0. This implies x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 0. So x is equal to 4. So put x is equal to 4 into this. So 4 minus 2 bracket 0 should be equal to 4. So 4, 2 multiplied by 0 is 0. So 4 is equal to 4. So yes, this is 4, 0 is a solution of this equation. Yes, 4, 0 is a solution of x minus 2y is equal to 4. Next, fourth part. root 2, 4 root 2. So this implies x is equal to root 2, comma y is equal to 4 root 2. So put x is equal to root 2 into this. So root 2 minus 2 bracket 4 root 2 should be equal to 4, or we can say root 2 minus 8 root 2 should be equal to 4, or we can say root 2 minus 8 root 2 is 7 root 2 minus, so minus 7 root 2 should be equal to 4. Since we all know minus 7 root 2 is not equal to 4, so answer is no. Next, fifth part, 1, 1. So this implies x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1. So put x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1 in above equation. So we have 1 minus 2 is equal to 4, or we can say minus 1 is equal to 4. So we all know a negative value can never be equal to a positive value, so answer is no. So correct option is third one, 4, 0. Next, fourth question. So in fourth question, we have find the value of k. If x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 is the solution of the equation. So equation is 2x plus 3y is equal to k. So if x is equal to 2, comma y is equal to 1. So put the values of x is equal to 2, x is 2. Y is 1, then find the value of k. So 2 multiplied 2 is 4 plus 3 is equal to k, or we can say k is equal to 7. So k answer is 7. So this is all about exercise 4.2.